Hey, this is Nick Mazing at Sentieo. It is May 2021, and I want to walk you through my X-Ray Fundamentals dashboard that I built to have a one-stop shop for visualizing fundamental data such as revenue growth, margins, free cash flow, share count, number of employees, cash conversion cycle, net debt to EBITDA, and so on. So if you want this dashboard, I can send it to your account executive or your customer success representative. They can push it to here through the share button. So what I did is I have 39 widgets, which I have loaded for Church and Dwight, and you can have a watch list here, and you can just click through and they will reload. So I have Church and Dwight with some metrics here. I have the basic valuation model widget, which you can see in the equity data terminal. I have the stock price over 10 years, but now this is where it gets interesting. It's all color coded. I basically took every income statement line item and I have it as a year over year change with the 10-year median. So for example, here in Church and Dwight, they actually do acquisitions periodically, which are those big bumps, but on an ongoing basis, their revenue growth has been 5.1% median for the last 10 years. And then, if you look at, let's say, their net income, it's been growing at 10.4%. So immediately, I know Church & Dwight is doing acquisitions periodically. They grow at about 5% top line, and then EPS grows at 10.4. That's really their algorithm. I have free cash flow year over year. Free cash flow tends to be spikier, so that's why you have some, big numbers year over year. Then, in green, and it's color-coded because I want it to be color-coded and stand out, is I have the margins across line items. Gross margin, EBITDA margin, EBIT margin, free cash flow margin, net income margin. Now, what you see is, again, I have the median. You can see the overall trend. You can see more recently things have been trending. Then, obviously, you can see COVID. Some companies took a margin hit. Some companies, their margins went up, with their COVID winners. But you can really see on a quarterly basis what's been going on and what is the overall trend versus the median. Then in red, I have valuation. Now you can see obviously Church and Dwight have done very well. In general, well, all the consumer multiples have been expanding. You can see EV to sales has expanded, EV to gross profit, EV to EBITDA, this is all on a next 12 month basis, EV to EBIT, next 12 months PE. But also, another thing that it is, I'm actually also looking at the relative PE. So this is the next 12 months against PE, against the S&P PE, and you can see that typically Church & Dwight trades at 1.5 and now it's actually at 1.3. So on a relative basis, even though the multiples have been expanding, also the market multiples have been expanding. And I have dividend yield. In case it's a stock that trades on dividend yield, you can see now the dividend yield is relatively low. They been trading around 1.5, now they're at around 1.2. I have last 12 month free cash flow yield and last 12 month free cash flow yield on EV, because in some cases the capital structure does matter. So this one is on market cap, this one is on EV. Then in light blue, I have credit metrics. I have net debt to EBITDA, and they did a big acquisition here in 2018. You can see, and that they've been bringing down the leverage. You can see here, I have interest coverage. I have free cash flow, and you can see that how much they pull in per quarter. You can see free cash flow has been trending up. Then in orange, I have performance metrics such as return on equity, return on invested capital, return on assets. Then I have the day sales outstanding. I have here the days payables. You can see they've been slower to pay their bills. And here I have days inventory. Now, days inventory, obviously, things got a little bit messed up with COVID. And you can see cash conversion cycle over the years generally has been pretty stable. But you can see whether the company has been able to do better in terms of cash conversion cycle. Some other things that I like looking at, again, in orange, diluted shares outstanding. You see whether companies are diluting their shareholders, whether they're buying back stock immediately right here. I like goodwill. Goodwill shows if there is a big jump, that's an acquisition. You can see they've had a bigger acquisition here, and then if their acquisition strategy hasn't been that great, you're going to see actually write-downs. In some cases, you see the write-downs here. Number of employees, generally, it's kind of another, using just the pure number of employees. I'm not doing anything like revenue per employee or anything like that. And then at the very bottom, I have the Wall Street consensus estimates from our IBIS integration with revenues, EBITDA, and EPS going out to 2023 in Church and Dwight's case. So again, if you I really like being able to have these 36 data viz widgets through our plotter that I built. And if you want this dashboard, again, we can share it right from here with I can share it with our timbers, who can then push it on to you.